Hi, I'm Kirsten Winquist from Radio Margaritaville, and I'm brand new to Nashville. So we're going to go on a tour today. I'm really excited to explore the city with you and see what we see. Come on, come join. This is 12 South, home to tons of charming coffee shops, vintage shopping, restaurants, bars, music. This spot has it all. We're going to go check out one of the famous restaurants here. It's called The Flipside. I'm trying a Bloody Mary.
If you're like me and you prefer your Bloody Mary to be more like lunch with tater tots, chicken, and a snow crab claw thrown in there, then the Big Fix is guaranteed to be the most epic way to begin your Nashville experience. Next, we head to 7th Avenue to check out Third Man Records, the official headquarters of Jack White's record label. Fascinating novelties from a bygone era are scattered throughout the store, such as the Wax-O-Matic machine, a full-color photo booth, even a recording studio where you can test out those singing chops. Oh, and don't forget to check out the in-house band. Nashville seems to have a knack for cool stuff and weird things. That leads us to our next spot. Cool stuff and weird things.
What's your favorite piece? If you had to pick one piece here that you just really love, what's your favorite?
Well, right now, my favorite piece is right behind you.
Is it?
It's a 1959, it's over there, the Swin Corvette. What you call a baby boomer bike. You know, there was a lot of baby boomers getting those in the 50s and 60s. You know, so.
I need a cruiser for Nashville because I'm moving here. Do you want to make me a deal on it?
Yeah, I'll give you a deal on it, hell yeah.
There's only one thing bigger than country music in Nashville, hot chicken. It's such a craze that people line up for hours to get their daily fix. The epicenter of the madness is located in a nondescript strip mall on the northeast side of town, Prince's Hot Chicken Shack.
So I'm thinking this is somebody after they've eaten the XXX hot. I'm definitely trying it now because I like being spicy. Is the triple X gonna kill me?
Yes, it is. Oh, you wanted me to lie to you, boo?
I'm not gonna lie to you, baby. Okay. That's gonna light you up.
This is a big Nashville deal, and I went ahead and ordered the extra, extra, extra hot. I've been instructed that it's on the bottom and that it might kill me, so we're gonna give this a shot.
The secret ingredient? Well, mainly, it's just a whole lot of cayenne. When 5 o'clock rolls around, what better way to recover from all that hot chicken than a cocktail by the water? Located just outside of town is Shipwreck Cove, a family-owned and operated oasis that sits right on the lake. Home of the best bushwhacker in all of Nashville and some of the finest southern hospitality. Don't be surprised if one of your new friends invites you out on their boat. Nashville is known as Music City, and when night falls, Nashvillians make their way to Lower Broadway, where the city comes alive with music. But before you honky-tonk into the wee hours, make a little time for dinner at my restaurant of choice, Margaritaville. Great authentic southern food, and the caliber of music that's expected in Nashville. Be on the lookout for an old guitar hanging on the wall. You might be looking at the first guitar Jimmy Buffett ever laid his hands on. Ready for some honky-tonk? Only a few steps away from Margaritaville lies the grandest honky-tonk of them all, Robert's Western World. Whether you like to take it slow like this gentleman, or dance like there's no tomorrow, Robert's Western World is pure old-school fun, featuring some of the finest talent around. The huge amount of artists and musicians in Nashville make it a fun, funky, eclectic city, and everyone here just wants to make you feel at home. They say about 100 people move here a day, and I'm excited to be one of them.